Well, ringside here, Dick Graham along with Ken Resnick, and I'll tell you, nonstop action. World Wrestling Federation, Ken, never stops.
No, it doesn't, Dick, and this matchup should be no exception, to say the least.
Let's get the introduction.
Ladies and gentlemen, this contest, one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Introducing the contestants. First gentleman weighs 263 pounds. He's from San Francisco, California, a Brutus Beefcake. And his opponent, he's from Quebec City. He weighs 245 pounds, Rick Martel.
Rick Martel hasn't been here for a little while at the Spectrum, but I'll tell you, the fans have not lost their desire for him. They love him. And also Brutus Beefcake, to be very honest with you, Ken.
I was a bit surprised, Dick. Brutus Beefcake had a fairly good round of applause.
Yep.
And Brutus still sporting the remnants of the inadvertent haircut he received at the hands of adorable Adrian Adonis.
For sure. Well, again, last-minute instructions from referee Joe Morella. As I say, Rick Martel looks just about the same he did a few years back when he last appeared at the Spectrum. Always a great crowd pleaser. Looks in great shape. Looks like he might be a little heavier than he had been, but well set up. He's been working out for sure.
As we talked about earlier, Dick, there's no question that he and Tom Zink, forming the Can-Am connection, are a definite force to be reckoned with in the tag team picture here in the World Wrestling Federation. They look better and better each and every time.
Well, yeah, that legend on the back of his jacket, the Can-Am connection, that's exactly what it is. And he's a great crowd pleaser. Nice to see him again.
And believe you me, Rick Martel, no stranger to singles competition, is a tremendous and a great accomplished single wrestler. And that may give him a little advantage, because I don't think Brutus Beefcake has wrestled as many single matches as has Rick Martel. And Brutus, of course, used to having Greg the Hammer Valentine in his corner.
Well, he had a lot of help there. Of course, a great lot of, not to take anything away from Beefcake, but a lot of coaching, too. A lot of the nuances of wrestling between Beefcake and Valentine when they're wrestling in tandem. Martel, though, I always liked his enthusiasm. He's got a great deal of energy, high energy, and he loved it. Yeah, he comes to get it on with you.
Now, I've known Rick Martel about 5-6 years, and you will not find a finer gentleman anywhere than he will Rick Martel.
He's really Mr. Clean Cut, deservedly so, and that's not a put down. This guy really is he's the epitome of what a wrestler should be. Everybody loves him.
He always has time for the youngsters.
Yep.
He'll sign autographs until the last fan has gone home. He's truly a fine gentleman. If you take nothing away from him, as accomplished a wrestler as you will find, he can do it all inside the ring. This should be a great matchup, and conspicuous by his absence tonight, luscious Johnny V nowhere to be found.
Yes, we miss him around here. Of course, we talk about the fans with Martel. The ladies like him a lot of bit.
he and Tom Zink, they don't come any better looking.
For sure.
And talk about two men with tremendous physiques. I think referee Joey Morella is going to have his hands full. Brutus Beefcake, not necessarily known for staying within the rule book.
Well, we understand from our Prism sources that a lot of mail comes in on Rick Martel and a young lady by the name of Elizabeth, who has captured the imagination of males wherever she's gone.
Not to say the same thing for her counterpart, if you will, or
Macho Man
Randy Savage.
Well,
Macho Man, of course, be going up against Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. WrestleMania 3, what a great matchup that is.
There are fans out there like the Steamboat a great deal.
George Animal Steel will be in the Dragon's corner.
Yeah, he's a great favorite of some of the fans, too, George Animal. Always goes with...
Brutus Beefcake doesn't seem real anxious to tie up with Rick Martel so far. A little bit hesitant now, they call it elbow hookup. Beefcake goes right for the side headlock.
Side headlock with his back turn, gave him a shot to the neck. Right around the throat, Rick Martel.
We couldn't see it from our vantage point, but I would be very surprised if it was the open palm, as he is telling referee Joey Morella, as opposed to a chop or thrust to the neck.
Well, Brutus was just telling referee Morella that he was using the open hand. Maybe, maybe not. He's got a lot of fans. All these ladies at ringside, they like Brutus Beefcake. They like his style.
He's a good-looking man. Can't take that away from him.
Quite a character. Martel, This energy is going to explode with Martell.
Rick has a tendency, he will try and lay back and go within the rules and try and be a very scientific wrestler until that French-Canadian temper of his lets loose, and then look out, and you must go head for the hills.
Don't get him angry, though.
Ooh. And Brutus Beefcake may have made a cardinal mistake
and
got Rick Martell angry because he is going toe-to-toe.
Don't you love it, fans?
Where'd he go? Beefcake says right there, Brutus, as Rick continues the onslaught.
A little side headlock and a shot to the
gentleman's
side of the head.
Gentleman from Quebec City right now is in high gear.
I love this energy. The guy is so enthusiastic. I love it. And he's a great wrestler to begin with.
Brutus Beefcake deciding that discretion is a better part of valor, or translated, it's better to be a live chicken than a dead duck, heads for the sanctuary of the ropes.
Well put, Ken. Beefcake's got to get it on. He can't plead his case to the referee. There's nothing going on there. He said, what's his thumb, the thumb, the thumb? Well, maybe, maybe not. Martell doesn't go that route, although he's using the clenched fist as a threat right now.
Beefcake's trying to decide what happened to Rick Martell. He was so nice and passive a few minutes ago.
Yeah, come on, Beefcake, get it on, man.
Now, Beefcake doing his best imitation of Muhammad Ali. Now, there is truly a rope-a-dope, I'll tell you right there.
Especially the dope.
Now, Beefcake, I don't know if he's trying to dig something out of his trunks or not.
Well, he's favoring his ear. He says, look, he's hurt me. It's injured.
He wants a little sympathy.
Yeah, none, not
very,
too much
very here. Little is what he's getting.
Martell, terrific looking guy. Look at him. Right on top of things. Side headlock by Beefcake, though. Monsoon called him Beef Steak many times.
The name fits.
Yeah, whatever. Still maintain that side headlock. They're pretty much from the front at this point.
Whoa,
trying to bulldog him down.
Rick tried to whip him off, and Beefcake just grabbed a head full of hair, something that he these days is putting a little less up.
Well, he's learned a lot. I don't mean to take anything away from Beefcake, but he learned a lot wrestling in tandem with Greg Valentine, of course. Great wrestling family, great tradition.
One
bonus forearm shot to the side. Got to break it up anyway. Morella right on top of it.
Joey Morella does a good job inside of that ring.
Well,
takes control when it needs to.
I don't know that.
Get right between
that's not
two.
Too smart, I don't think, getting between these two guys. Side headlock on Martell again. Gets rid of him. Oh, nice maneuver. Nice. All right.
Two games of leap.
Oh! Arm drag, takedown. He's right on top of him, putting pressure on that arm. Twisting, turning.
Goes right into the arm bar. Yeah. Turns it around, and that'll bring Beefcake up on his toes.
Well, the point, I thought, that the timekeeper briefly. I don't know what that was all about. A couple of knee lifts to the midsection. Third, fourth. Come on, Rick, got to get out of this one. Five, six, Rick. Into the turnbuckles. Oh, look out. Nobody home.
It looked like he waited just a little too long to make his run, Dick, and it cost him. He telegraphed it and gave Rick just enough time to get out of
there. He says, shall I make him a boy soprano or should I? Yeah, baby. Drop the boot. Drop the boot. A couple of knees to the...
Right to the hamstring area.
That's smart.
Martell, being a gentleman, opted for the hamstrings rather than the, shall we say, lower midsection. But nonetheless, as you see the result, the damage was certainly done.
Sure.
He goes into a toe hold.
Well, he stretched those legs, and sometimes the muscles in a man's workouts aren't meant to go that way. They kind of constrict more than extend.
Beefcake's got to be careful twice now. Joey Morella's coming to the count of two.
Yep.
He keeps those shoulders down for one more, and Martell will go home with one in the wind column.
A little step over toe hold there by Martell on Beefcake. Still maintaining pressure. That's that weak leg. I don't know how weak it is or how weak it's going to be, but he's working on it.
Very good point, Dick. Brutus Beefcake throughout his career has been known to play possum on many of occasions.
But
I think Martell's a little too smart.
Well, broke the hold. Nice maneuver by Beefcake. Oh, nice kick out. Martell, quick as can be, right on top of Beefcake. Comes down on that muscle again. Uh-oh. Gonna work on him now.
Well, as they say, what's good for the goose is good for the gander. And Rick Martell decides turnabout is fair play. There's a good look.
Always turnabout.
Rick Martell, Quebec City, Canada. Brutus Beefcake now driving the elbow into the sternum area of Martell and is able to lay him right back down.
Well, all fair. Drop the leg on him. Short leg drop, actually. Martell a little woozy right now. He's getting his message from outer space somewhere. He's wild, but look at him. Trying to clear the cobwebs.
Now, Beefcake may have waited again a little bit too long instead of going right in after him. Referee ordering the break. Joey Morello right on top of things.
Well, of the two, Beefcake is nobody's fool, but he tends to be a little more of a plodding wrestler as opposed to a very quick wrestler, energetic, high-energetic wrestler like Martell. Working on the midsection.
Here we go. I've got an idea. We're going to see that French-Canadian temper of Martell's, but Beefcake turns it around.
Oh, bear hook. Chuck him off the top rope right across the throat. He's in bad trouble.
He hit that top rope just like a slingshot effect right across the larynx, Dick.
The timing was beautiful, if you want to call it that. Could have been neater. Phew.
Beefcake now going right back after it. Martell right now is in some serious trouble.
Beefcake, he can say he's starting to struggle, but he's in control, he says. Because he was shot forearm in the midsection.
Martell is angry. You can always tell, Dick, when he comes up with both of his fists clenched, but I don't know if that's going to help him now if he'll get the opportunity.
Is this payback time, I wonder? Uh-huh. He's taking a lot of time, like you say, Kane. Headbutt to the lower regions, put it that way.
Goes for a cover. I think he's just riding too high. There you see the strength of Rick Martell.
No doubt.
Now there again, if Beefcake had been smart, if he would have slid off to the side, hooked the leg, and covered him with his full body, he might have been able to gain a count of three, but he's not going to do it that way.
Count of two, and a nice bridge.
Look at the deck bridge.
Oh, nice bridge by Martell. Look at all the weight. Took all the Beefcake weight to get that body down.
Martell was hoping for.
Beefcake wound up like he was going to do it to him. Martell merely brought his legs up, brought his knees up, rather, right to the midsection. And that's all she wrote. See where we go from here.
Oh. Atomic drop. I don't know if he landed quite square. It looks like a leg is a little wobbly of Martell's as well, Dick. Beefcake with a mule kick and now a knee lift right to the chin. So far, you'd have to give Brutus Beefcake the edge in this one as he's been in control most of the time.
He has. Maybe a body slam? Or what? Whoa! Show of strength there, huh? Well, if those tights come off, we're x-rated. We're out of business.
Brings him right down. The backbreaker goes for the cover. Well, should have hooked the leg.
Now Martell's, he's getting angry now. Oh, yeah, there he is. He's upset. You've said enough of this stuff.
Sometimes it takes Rick Martell just to absorb so much punishment and then
get the pressure right on the eyes, though, being worn away by Morella. Brought back the same old stuff. Oh, nails right across the back.
I think Mr. Beefcake is in danger of awakening a sleeping Rick Martell about now.
Well, look like it. Kicked out, using the ropes for himself. Beefcake down, Martell not in great shape, but he's fighting back.
He's trying to clear the cobwebs. He's still a bit groggy, but...
Well, right across the top rope, right across the eyes, man. Beefcake, he should be right on top of Martell. Now he is. Drives that shoulder into him. He's got to be in shape to take that kind of punishment the way Martell has.
Well, we talked about it. So many wrestlers seem to, their egos seem to get in the way of them following right up on their opponents. And right there was a prime example. You've got to learn to ignore the crowd and concentrate solely on your opponent.
Still a bear hug on Martell by Beefcake, kind of cranking it up. Martell really in pain. And the fist is not the way to go, says referee Mark Morella.
Now, we don't talk about it as often, perhaps, as we should, but look at the forearms and upper arms of Brutus Beefcake. He's got some power up there as well.
He does.
Now, Beefcake going outside. Looks like he's deciding he's going to try and go upstairs. very dangerous territory for Brutus Beefcake.
Oh! Caught it in the middle.
Found out.
That looked like a good idea for a moment, but turned out not to be. Martel is in cinch, man. He says, come on, I need you.
Best
payback time.
Best laid plans of mice and men often go awry. Brutus Beefcake, an example of that, personified.
Off the top turnbuckle. Oh!
Oh, Martel's in high gear now.
He's got two more turnbuckles to go, but that's his idea. Taking back to the first one again. Beefcake is wobbly, crashed like a tall timber. Martel's going to go for it. Almost.
Very close. Kind of 2.5. But referee Joey Morello is right on top of it. Martel very much in control right now. Off the rope comes Beefcake. Martel with an abdominal stretch.
Well, this might be, I don't know. Can Martel maintain the hold?
He doesn't have it quite well. He couldn't get that one leg hooked around Beefcake. Beefcake hip-tossed it, sensed it, and took Martel down.
Oh, nobody home. Everybody left down. He's going to do a double chop on him. Oh, look. Oh, sleeper. Sleeper now. Does he have him? I don't know. Martel's holding on. I don't think he, well, maybe he does.
Didn't quite have it on him well enough. Beefcake, very smart, driving Martel into the turnbuckle.
And half turning, but too.
Martel holding on.
No, both of them outside the ring. Beefcake down on one knee. Martel on all fours. Now he's back up. He's got to get back inside the ring. Count of 4 or 5 by the referee. Grabs it by the tights. Uh-oh.
Woo.
Look out. Well, the action's outside the ring. Smashes his head on the apron. Beefcake wants back in. So does Martel. Uh-oh.
We'll have to wait for the call by Joey Morella. I don't know if one man didn't get back in time of the count of 10 or not, but
time expired. I don't know. Well, still going on as far as the two wrestlers are concerned. Morella stepping in between them. It's all over, man, he said. It's all over. The bell rang. All right. Well, it's still. Well, let's get the official here.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Joe Morella has ruled a double count out. This contest is a draw. A draw.
Well, there you have it. Neither man's like kissing your sister, they say. No decision. All right, let's check it out, fans. Stay tuned for more of the excitement of the World Wrestling Federation action from the Spectrum exclusively.